Here we go again with the Trademo Show with Matthias and Sebastian.
Hello everyone.
Hey. Today with Index Day, Russell 2000. Yeah, Matthias, I know one of your favorite indices. Yeah. Tell us more about it. Why? Where does this passion for the Russell come from?
This is a funny thing because you already mentioned passion, and it is passion. But the reason for my passion is that this indice is not that index, volatile index. Compared to
the
just
index in English.
Okay, index. Yeah, is not that volatile as, for example, the S&P 500, the Nasdaq, or the Dow Jones. And for my strategy, for my options strategy, I sell put butterflies. Mm-hmm. And if you do that, then it is very important that your index is not so volatile. And the volatility in the Russell 2000 is not that much. And this is good. And yeah, it's less nerve-wracking. It's a convenient way to trade an index if you choose the Russell 2000.
Okay, then let's take a look at the chart. I won't go into the option trading details, what you've alluded to here, because I know this would be too much for this show. But we'll have a full education program around this at Trademo soon, so we'll keep you updated about this. Now, looking at the Russell 2000, how can you say that it's not volatile if I look at the last couple of weeks? Okay, let's say historically it's been not as volatile as the S&P. Let's look at the S&P in comparison over the last couple of weeks. And yeah, I think I would have been much more comfortable going long on the S&P than on the Russell. But the...
But if you compare both indexes to the last 5 years or so,
plural is fine. Indices is the plural and index the singular. Now you have all combinations.
Okay. I think in the S&P and especially in the Nasdaq, you will see a lot of very strong moves to the upside or to the downside. So maybe 10 or 15% is not that rarely. And in the Russell 2000, it's very, it's not that often to you see increase or decrease of 10% in just a short period of time. So let's say maybe 2 months. Russell 2000 has a historical volatility of only 7 or 8%, which is very, very low. And yeah, this makes it easy to trade options on the Russell and makes it more difficult to trade options on the Nasdaq, for example.
Okay, understood. Then let's take a look at another way to trade the Russell. It's the IWM. So just to also show that, that's the ECF. So if you have less capital, then this is how you would trade the Russell. But Matthias, tell us more about what does the Russell consist of? Which companies are in the Russell?
The Russell 2000 is an index of 2,000 medium-sized companies of America, of US. Mm-hmm. For example, the S&P 500 contains all the 500 biggest and largest companies, I think, based on market capitalization, and the Russell 2000 contains 2,000, the medium-sized companies of the U.S. So it's, compared to the German, for example, it's the MDAX, and I think almost every country on Earth had a big index and some smaller ones, and the Russell 2000 is, as I said,
the mid cap index.
The mid cap index. Yeah, this is what I'm looking.
It's not the small cap either. So it's really mid cap.
No. It's mid cap. Maybe there are some small capitalized companies in it. In general, I would say it's the medium capitalized companies.
Okay. Good. And then just to for the end of this show, What's your analysis? What's your expectation of the Russell over the next couple of weeks?
Oh, so no comments, I would say.
Okay, then let me ask this way, like, how are you positioned in the Russell yourself at the moment?
I'm always, so this is part of the strategy. I'm always short in the Russell. So a put butterfly profits from the Russell goes sideways, maybe slightly upwards, but it makes really money if it goes down. And as you can see on the chart or at the chart, the Russell went up for the last 6 or 7 weeks. Yeah, and this was pretty painful for my account.
Understand. But why do you have this general sideways strategy or downward strategy for the Russell?
Yeah, when you look at the markets in general, then indices, I learned that, indices, yeah, mostly go sideways. So
Yeah,
there is
if you look on a daily
the
chart
majority
here
of the
at
time
the
exposed.
IWM, I have a daily chart open here. Then yeah, you're right that for weeks on yeah, there's just like 2 weeks always of rally and then maybe 8 weeks of sideways
Yeah,
here on
then calm
this chart.
down and take some breath, and then the market goes up or down. But in the most time, markets go sideways, and this strategy is created for such environment.
Okay. Look forward to learning more about the strategy at Trademore.com when the live education for this and the Nano Diploma are ready. But more about this in the next coming weeks.
Yes.
Okay. Then thank you for this insight, Matthias, for today.
Yeah, you're welcome, Sebastian. You're welcome.
See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow, guys. Bye.